Hi students, myself Anirvan Basurai Choudhury, Lab Assistant, Department of Chemistry, JS College of Engineering. You are watching the lab video. The paper name is Chemistry 1 Lab. This is for BTech first year students. And the paper code is CH191 and CH291.
Hello students. Today I'm going to discuss about the experiment. The interesting one, the determination of the partition coefficient of a substance between two immiscible liquids. The partition coefficient experiment. Okay. Now, what do you understand by immiscible liquid? The immiscible is the property where two substances are not capable of combining to form a homogeneous mixture, like oil and water. You know. It will not mix. Okay, it is not mixed to get the homogeneous. That is the immiscible liquid. Now, when a system consists of a part which have different physical property and are separated by the boundary surface, thus the system is said that to be a heterogeneous one. So we are considering that heterogeneous equilibrium. That is also called heterogeneous equilibrium. That's why. Okay, now in this experiment, we have to prove or we have to show the Nernst distribution law. So, what is the Nernst distribution law? What it is say? The Nernst distribution law states that at constant temperature is constant. At a constant temperature, when different quantities of a solute are allowed to distribute between two immiscible solvents in contact with each other, then at the equilibrium, the ratio of the concentration, remember the ratio of the concentration of the solute in two layers are constant at a constant temperature. Okay, so that we have to prove by doing our experiment today. Now, in our experiment, what we are taking, so consider a liquid system. There we are taking N-butanol and water, that is as two immiscible liquid. And if the acetic acid, we take little bit acetic acid into that part, will dissolve partly, then acetic acid will dissolve partly in water and partly in N-butanol. So in that time, whenever we add into acetic acid into water and butanol, the acetic acid will not distribute properly. So the solution should be shaken vigorously. So after shaken of the solution, then in a definite manner, acetic acid will go in both the layers, like acid, organic and aqueous. Okay. Now, the two solutions of acetic acid will separated into two layers at the equilibrium. The concentration of acetic acid in the layers is different. Maybe it is different, but their ratio is fixed at a constant temperature. It is a Nernst distribution law. Okay, so this is the theoretical part. Now, in our experiment, we are taking the reagent, as I told, N-butanol, water and acetic acid. Two normal acetic acid we have to take. Another, for titration, we are taking N/2 sodium hydroxide solution. Okay, and apparatus which are required, conical flask, then 250ml conical flask, burette, pipette, also a separating funnel. That is a new one. Separating funnel is used here. So those are the apparatus which is required for the titration. Okay. Now, in the procedure part, we have to take two bottles. So we can take more than two also. So we are taking here two bottles. We will consider bottle one and bottle two. So in bottle one, what we have to take? We have to take 50 ml of, we are differentiate bottle and bottle 1 and bottle 2, the volume will be different. Like we are taking in bottle 1 50 ml of N-butanol, 50 ml of water and 50 ml of normal acetic acid. Whereas in the bottle 2, we are taking 75 ml of N-butanol, 75 ml of normal acetic acid. Okay, that means you see in the two bottles, the volumes are different. We are taking different volumes. And after shaking of the two bottles, that means layers are formed. Whenever we add the solution, you see two layers. One is organic in the upper part, that is organic layer, I will show you. And in the lower part, the aqueous layer. At that point, acetic acid will not go properly. For that, vigorous shaking is required. So after shaking, we'll show the ratio. Maybe the acetic acid will go in the layer in different like volume, but the ratio of the concentration is at the equilibrium at a constant temperature, it is same. That you have to prove. Now in the bottle 2, one question is there. In bottle 2, look, we are taking only N-butanol and 2 normal acetic acid. Okay, now I told that organic and aqueous layers are formed, but for bottle 2, you see there is no water is added separately. Then how we get the aqueous layer? Now the aqueous layer is coming from that part. We are preparing 2 normal of acetic acid. It is not glacial acetic acid. Okay, so we have prepared a solution of 2 normal. So the water is coming from there. This question will be asked in the 5 also. It's a practical oriented question. Okay, students. Now watch the video carefully. Now I am showing you the practical part and how we do the partial condition experiment. Okay. Watch carefully. Now students, the practical part, that means how we do the experiment in the laboratory, I will show you. So look at carefully. Reagents are available there, like N-butanol, 2 normal acetic acid. Okay. And what is there? Now there are 2 bottles, as I consider, that is bottle 1 and that is bottle 2. 2 bottles are prepared, we have to prepare. So you have to take the solution in bottle 1 and bottle 2. So first of all, for bottle 1, what we have to take? We have to take 50 ml of N-butanol, 50 ml of water, 50 ml of 2 normal acetic acid by a measuring cylinder. So 3 measuring cylinders are available. First of all, we have to take N-butanol. So, very easy. So, take 50 ml of N-butanol. Then acetic acid, 2 normal acetic acid, 50 ml. So 250 ml, 2 normal acetic acid. Then 50 ml of water. So it is taken in bottle 1. Okay. Now bottle 1 is prepared. Now look. Immediately after adding the solution, look, layers are formed, 2 phases are there. So at the bottom, that is the aqueous part, and in the upper, that is the organic part. Okay, so immediately after that, after filling the pouring the solution or mixing the solution, you will see 2 different phases. Can you see 2 phases? One layer, one layer is formed. Okay, now this is bottle 1. Now for bottle 2, you have to take 75 ml of N-butanol, as I told, 75 ml of N-butanol. Okay. Next, 75 ml of acetic acid. All the solutions are transparent, so you have to take the lower meniscus for all. Now, 75 ml of acetic acid. We are not taking the water for bottle 2, and as I discussed, that water is coming, the aqueous phase is coming from that 2 normal acetic acid, because we are not giving glycyl acetic acid. Look, for bottle 2 also, 2 layers are formed. Okay, 2 phases are there, organic and aqueous, layers are formed. That means, whenever we fill the bottle, immediately after that, we loop the 2 phases or layers. That means, in that particular time, acetic acid will partly in organic layer and partly in aqueous. But it will not go properly. So that's why vigorous shaking is required. Okay, vigorous shaking. So if the mechanical shaker is available, then you can put it into mechanical shaker. Otherwise, you have to shake by your hand like this. Close the stopper, and by round up manner, you have to shake vigorously. Not gently, vigorously you have to shake. Okay, so vigorous shaking is required for both the bottles. That is the so-called difficult part. That means it will be much time consuming. So if you do that practical in a group, say 2 or 3 students are there, say one by one, and say at least 30 minutes, 30 to 40 minutes, you have to shake it vigorously. Otherwise, acid will not go properly in both the layers. So vigorous shaking is required. Okay? So this is the process of shaking. Clear? Now, for bottle 2 also, same thing. Okay, so after shaking, what you have to do? After shaking, you have to keep either if you have separating funnel. Now this is the separating funnel. This is separating funnel. So if you have separating funnel, very easily we can separate the 2 layers. Like the process is like this. You have to pipette it out. You have to pipette it out. Acetic acid from organic layer, as well as you have to pipette out acetic acid from aqueous layer, and you have to pipette out 5 ml for each case. Okay, now if you have the separating funnel, it is very very easy for separate the two phases, and then we have to take the or collect the or pipette out the solution very easy. Otherwise, it is a little bit difficult to pipette out the solution from that bottle. Because whenever we take the upper part, that is acetic acid from organic layer, so your pipette should be within that layer. And if we take the acetic acid from aqueous layer, the lower part, then your pipette should be within that aqueous layer. Okay, otherwise errors are coming. And in that case, you have to pipette it out very carefully, because you have to pipette it out in one time. Otherwise, if you drop the solution, if some mistakes are there, whenever we do the pipetting, some mistakes are there. What happens? We just again put it into that particular bottle. But in that case, if you drop it into that bottle, what happens? It will be mess up. And again, you have to take some time for resting that solution. So pipetting, whenever we pipette from that bottle directly, it is little bit difficult. But if we use the separating funnel, then it is much easier. Okay. Now see what happened. So now you have to pour that solution into the separating funnel. the shaking. We have to pour it. Now you have to separate it one part carefully. Open the plate and separate it. Up to that, this part, the lower part, the aqueous part, will be separated into one bottle. In another bottle, we have to take the another. It is very easy if you have separated funnel. Okay. If you separate the two layer, two phase, like organic and aqueous, then very easily you can keep it out. Now 5 ml liquid is required. Okay. And the burette, after that you have to titrate it against N/2 NOI solution. So burette should be rinsed with N/2 NOI solution, which is already filled. One is the upper part, organ. So we will separate. This one is the aqueous layer and this one is the organ. So by separating funnel, very easily we are separating that which is the organ. Now we have to pipette it out in two different washed conical flasks, 5 ml. So we can use the sakar also, because a very bad smell is there. So if you won't pipette it by now, then sakar may be used. Okay. So this is the organic layer. Because in the separating part, in the lower part, first of all we are separating the lower part, that is aqueous. This is organ. It's very easy by sakar. That's the tip. This is 5 ml. Now another pipette, 5 ml pipette, you have to pipette it out the which one? The lower part, the aqueous. From aqueous layer, the acidic acid, 5 ml. So you can prepare it out by your mouth or maybe suffer. So this is the aqueous. Acetic acid from aqueous. Okay. Now we have to add some distilled water in it. Because 5 ml is very less. Then the indicator is phenylophthalein. So 1 drop of phenylophthalein. Here also we are giving 10. So indicator is added. Now you have to start the titration. So titration, you know before starting you just check the initial reading. Okay. Now in the acid phenylophthalein is there. What should be the color change? Colorless to pink, because this is the NO solution in my tube. Now check the initial reading. And start titration. In 1 drop, color should be changed. So add drop by drop. The local point is coming. Start the clinical flask. Okay, so color is changed, pink color is appeared. Okay, so titration is finished. That is for acid, for bottle. We are doing the titration for bottle 1, remember. It is a lengthy process. So for bottle 1, that is the acetic acid from organic layer. That means the first titration. Okay. So check the reading, that is the final reading. So final minus initial, you will get the consumed volume and note down in a copy and put it in the table. Okay. Now the next that is the acetic acid from aqueous. So that also should be titrated. Now indicator phenylophthalein, same indicator. The color change will be colorless to pink. Now again you see the initial experiment. When you start the experiment, initially you see the initial reading, then you have to start the titration. You see that some local point is coming, color is changing, need 1 drop, color should be changed. It's coming. Whenever end point is coming in 1 drop, color, all the colors should be transferred into pink. Okay, see, pink color is appearing. So second titration is also finished. Now you check again the final reading. So final minus initial, you will get your consumed value. So this titration is done for bottle 1. That means for bottle 1, 2 titration. One is acetic acid from organic layer, another acetic acid from aqueous layer. We are taking it to conical flask and titrating it is in my tube. Now the same procedure we have to do for bottle 2. That means you have to take the bottle 2 don't forget to shake the solution vigorously after at least 30 minutes. So after that you have to put it into a separating funnel. Then you have to separate the two phase or two layers into different bottles. Then from that bottle you have to bring out again 5 ml acetic acid from organic layer and 5 ml from aqueous for bottle 2. And then again you have to add the indicator, phenylophthalein, and do the titration and note down the reading. Okay, so this is the practical part, which is a very lengthy process. That means it will take some time, but not very difficult one. Okay. So I think all of you enjoyed and understood the video of the titration method. Now the next part, we will explain you the calculation part. Okay, so see the video, watch the video carefully. Okay, so students, now the last part, of this experiment, that is the calculation part. You have done the experiment process, and I think you have understood that. So now you have to fill up the table. So table is look like that. First one, bottle number, that is bottle 1 and bottle 2. The next column, layup table, that is organic aqueous, and for bottle 2 also organic and aqueous. Now every time that layup should be 5 ml, because the bottle 5 we are making 5 ml. So now consider the repeating is like that. For bottle 1 organic that is 7.5, for aqueous layer aqueous that is 6.5, and for bottle 2 is 11. Aqueous 9.5. Consider this is the value which is coming after titration. Okay, so maybe whenever you do the experiment, it will be different. Now this is the table. Now this part after calculation you will find out. Now the calculation part. The calculation is very easy, but it is very lengthy one. So don't worry, it is very easy, but you have to do same calculation again and again. That's why it is lengthy. So the calculation is like that. For bottle 1, first of all you have to calculate for bottle 1. So for bottle 1, acetic acid in organic layer, we have to find out the strength of acetic acid. Acetic acid for organic layer, using formula V1 is the volume of acetic acid, which will be 5 ml. If we are putting 5 ml, V2 volume of mineral solution, that will be 7.5, that is the Boudet rating according to that table. Then this one, strength of acetic acid, that you have to determine. Now the strength of NaOH, that is N by 2, which is supply. Now we have to put the value and we will get this one, that is 0.75 normal. That is the acetic strength of acetic acid for organic. Now for bottle 1, again you have to determine the strength of acetic acid in aqueous. Again that formula, V3H3T4S4, is the combination of that. Where V3 is the volume of acetic acid, that is 5 ml, V4 is the volume of NaOH solution. From that table, it is 6.5, the HCF number, S4 is the N by 2. So after plotting, you will get this value, 0.65 normal. That is the S3 strength of acetic acid for organic, aqueous layer in bottle 1. Okay, now next part, that is equation 1 and equation 2. So from that equation, the partition coefficient of acetic acid in bottle 1, that is K1, consider the K1, that is the partition coefficient, is equal to S1 by S2, organic by aqueous, is equal to C1 by C2, where C1 and C2 is the concentration of acetic acid. So whenever you do the calculation, say it is coming 1.153, that is the partition coefficient of acetic acid for bottle 1. Now same calculation you have to do it again for bottle 2. Okay, if exactly everything is same, only different that part, that is the purity. This will be different. Other thing like strength of NaOH, volume of acetic acid is same. Okay, now it is for organic layer and acetic acid for aqueous layer. For bottle 2, there also you have to change that value. So according to that table, you have to put it there, say 11, and here 9.5. Then we will consider for bottle 2 K2, that is the partition coefficient of acetic acid for bottle 2, that will be 1.1 divided by 0.95. Okay, so it is coming, say 1.157. So from bottle 1, the partition coefficient is coming this, and for bottle 2, that is coming. Okay, now the mean partition coefficient of acetic acid between N-butanol and water, that will be K is equals to K1 plus K2 divided by 2. K1 plus K2 divided by 2 is coming 1.15. So this is the mean partition coefficient there. Okay, so you understand, students, that when we are taking in different volume of acetic acid, and all the solutions are taken different volume, but whenever we take the ratio, it will be more or less same in a constant temperature. Okay, so say today's room temperature, that should be, let me say, 32 degrees centigrade. Okay, this is the constant temperature. In constant temperature, the ratio is same. Okay, students, so this is all about the partial coefficient experiment. I think you'll enjoy it. And okay, see you in the next class. Thank you, students.